There are many different types of som tam or green papaya salad in Thailand. So today I'm sharing how to make two main recipes. The first one is the common som tam from central Thailand that we call Som Tam Thai. And the other is Som Tam Pla-Ra from Isan, the northeast region where my hometown is located. Each recipe is for 4 servings. The ingredients needed are green papaya strands from 1 medium-sized papaya, soaked in the ice cube, pestle and mortar, fish sauce, pickled fish sauce or plara, concentrated tamarind water, coconut sugar syrup for Thai salad, bird eye chilies, long beans, tomato, lime, garlic, sugar, roasted peanut, and dry shrimps. I am serving the 2 som tams with fresh long beans cabbage and homemade crispy pork rind. The full list of ingredients and recipe are in the CMO link. First, I'm making som tam pla-ra. It is very spicy, sour and pungent. So I am adding 6 to 8 pieces of mixed red and green bird eye chili with the stem removed. 2 cloves of garlic and a bit of papaya strand to prevent the chili from splashing out from the mortar. Pound until the chili and garlic are finely smashed. Like this. Then cut 1.5 tomato into thin slices right into the mortar. By the way, this is the authentic way of making som tam. Be careful when doing this. You can also cut it ahead of time on the chopping board. Squeeze 1 whole lime into the mortar. This is about 1 tablespoon of lime juice, about 3/4 tablespoon of fish sauce, 1 tablespoon of pickled fish sauce or plara. Half tablespoon of concentrated tamarind water and 1 tablespoon of sugar. Gently mix all the ingredients in the mortar until well combined with the pesto. Now I can taste it. It's like saltiness, so I am adding 1/2 tablespoon of plara and mix it again. Alright, this time it's done. The sauce should be strongly spicy, sour with the perfect balance of sweetness and saltiness. Add just a handful of papaya and gently pound to mix until combined. This makes the papaya extract and reabsorb the sauce, mellowing the sauce and taking on its flavor. Give it a taste. This is great. More seasoning can be added, but for this, it is perfect and appetizing. Transfer to a serving plate. I can't wait to enjoy it. Next, I am continuing with Som Tam Thai. Wash and dry the mortar and pesto. Tam Thai is normally not so spicy, so I am only adding 5 pieces of bird eye chili. Two cloves of garlic and a little bit of papaya strands. Pound until finely smashed. Add in about a handful of cut long beans, about 1.5 inch in length. Smash them lightly, like this. It is done when some of them are broken and some are intact. Now add in 2 tablespoons of coconut sugar syrup for Thai salad, 1.5 tablespoons of fish sauce, and 1 tablespoon of concentrated tamarind water. Squeeze 1 lime, which is about 1 tablespoon of lime juice. Add the sliced tomato from 1.5 tomato. And gently pound to mix it. I am removing the towel underneath as the mortar shakes too much. There, much better. Okay, now I can taste it. It is good, but lacks sourness. Add about 1/2 tablespoon of lime juice, 1/2 tablespoon of fish sauce, and 1 tablespoon of coconut syrup. Pound gently to mix again. Then add all the papaya strand. Gently pound until well combined. Give it a taste. It is delicious. It should be sweet and sour. More seasoning can be added if preferred. Next, add about 3 tablespoons of dry prawns and 2 tablespoons of roasted peanut. Bow to mix again. Give it a taste. Now, this is perfect. The peanut makes it creamy and dry prawn make it fragrant and umami. Transfer the som tam to a serving plate. Garnish with some dry prawns and roasted peanut. And the delicious som tam thai is ready to be served. Let's eat the som tam thai first. It's delicious. Crunchy, sour, sweet, and a bit of saltiness. And it's not spicy. The peanut and dry prawn enhance the flavor and fragrance. So good! Now we try som tam pla-ra. Wow, this is really good. Sour, spicy, salty, super umami from the fish sauce and pla-ra. It goes so well with the crunchiness of papaya. So delicious. Enjoy it with crispy pork rind. Oh yes, it is really heavenly. Which of these som tam have you tried? Let me know in the comment. Thank you for watching. Please like and share if you have enjoyed this video. This is Home Cooking with Somjit. Thank you and bye bye.